Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome. This is Somaliland National Television and you watch the English news program with me, Mohamed Jibril. Here the story is making main headlines. President of Somaliland meets a delegation from the UK. Vice President of Somaliland cast the weapon of a new CID facility. High security in Iraq to counter attack during religious holiday of Ashura. President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyo, received a delegation from the United Kingdom led by the Anti-Terrorism Office for the United Kingdom government to discuss ways of enhancing cooperation between the two nations. President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyo, received a delegation from the United Kingdom at the Presidential Palace of Somaliland. This delegation was led by the head of the Anti-Terrorism Office for the United Kingdom government. The aim of this meeting was to enhance the cooperation between the two governments toward the fight against terror in Horn of Africa. These officials also deliberated on strengthening the support UK government provides to Somaliland government. President of Somaliland Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyo provided a brief remark to the media on the outcomes of the meeting, mentioned that Somaliland government will cooperate with the UK to stand against the terror activities in Horn of Africa to sustain the peace and stability Somaliland benefits from. Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyo also elaborated on the diplomatic ties between the two nations. UK government supports Somaliland on the economic and political stability which Somaliland managed to sustain. On the other hand, the head of the Anti-Terrorist Department for the UK government also held post-meeting with the Somaliland Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mohamed Bihi Yonis. The head of the Anti-Terrorism Department for the United Kingdom government also cut a ribbon for a criminal investigation department implemented in the capital of Somaliland, Hargeisa. This office is funded by the United Kingdom government. The head of the Anti-Terrorism Department for the UK government, speaking at the event, stated,
"The Minister has just said today we opened a world-class facility, a CID facility here in Hargeisa, which the British government has funded and which my department, the Counter-Terrorism Department of the Foreign Commonwealth Office, has funded."
Somaliland President hosted several international dignitaries at a banquet event held at the Presidential Palace of Somaliland.
The banquet event had several international dignitaries from the Netherlands, Denmark, the East African Development Organization, IGAD, and the World Bank. At the banquet event, the Netherlands ambassador to Somaliland and Somalia announced that the Netherlands government would join the Somaliland Development Fund and reaffirmed his government's commitment to closely cooperating with the Somaliland government on mutual interests of both nations.
Of the bilateral relation between Somaliland and the Netherlands, we try to bring companies here, we try to invest ourselves here, we see more Somaliland, Dutch people in Somaliland.
Minister of Foreign Affairs Mohamed Bihi Yonis, speaking at the banquet event, stated that the Somaliland government assures welcome to all sorts of development and commended the Netherlands government for determining to join the Somaliland Development Fund.
"I think it's a pressure for all of us tonight as Somalilanders to see the Netherlands joining the SDF, the Somaliland Development Fund."
Other notable guests speaking on behalf of their respective countries and international organizations commended Somaliland for playing a pivotal role in its country's development as well as assisting with the regional and continental development strategies.
"So I would like to welcome the government of the Netherlands, as I think it's probably called."
President of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanyo, also speaking at the event, stressed the necessity of strengthening ties with the world, both in development and security. The president pledged that Somaliland will remain committed to participating in development efforts and cooperating with all the countries.
Thank you very much indeed. It's a great pleasure to have you all here. We are very, my government and I, we are very happy to have you all here and to appreciate the support and the contribution that has been made for our development. We welcome you all.
Vice President of Somaliland, Abdulrahman Abdullahi Ismail Sayli'i, accompanied by cabinet ministers, opened a new headquarters for the Criminal Investigation Department, in which Abdulrahman Ahmed Fohle was appointed as a chairman.
Newly appointed chairman of the newly constructed CID facility, Abdulrahman Ahmed Fohle, stated that this center needs to be expanded in order to perform more tasks and achieve better results while investigating the incidents. He said that this facility will work upon the strict laws and regulations of the government of Somaliland. Minister of Finance Abdulaziz Mohamed Somali highlighted that opening this facility was among the top plans in the pipeline for the current administration. On the other hand, Minister of Presidency Hirsi Haji Ali further clarified that Somaliland's government pledges to continue providing further assistance to develop the work output of the CID facilities, nonetheless developing crucial sectors such as police and armed forces, and direct greater attention into finding ways of strengthening these departments in one of the priorities of the government of Somaliland. Conclusively, Vice President of Somaliland Abdulrahman Abdullah Ismail Saili announced that this headquarters will be funded by the UK government as a way to strengthen relations between the two governments. The Vice President dwelt further on the historical relationship and the diplomatic ties between the two countries and the current engagement taking place.
Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Mineral Resources Ali Chamac Bured held a meeting with the various governmental officials from Selat and Saylac region. Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Mineral Resources Ali Chamac Bured held a meeting with the governmental officials of Selat region. Minister of Fisheries and Mineral Resources Hussein Towa to Selat region held a discussion meeting with the officials of that region at the local government office of Saylac district. This meeting was attended by the governor of Selat region and his deputy, the coordinator of Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Mineral Resources, the chairman of Saylac district. The agendas discussed in this meeting were focusing on the enhancement of fisheries in that region and the role the ministry plays. The chairman of Saylac district also spoke at the event and admired the role of Somaliland Minister of Fisheries to improve the opportunities and advantage of the mineral resource in Saylac region. The chairman also sent gratitude to the Minister Ali Chamac Bured. Somaliland Minister of Fisheries and Mineral Resources also elaborated on the policies and plans of the ministry to improve fisheries in that region. The minister also stated that the ministry is on the last stage of implementing port in Saylac region to upgrade the advantages and opportunities of marine resources in that region. Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance Abdullahi Mohamed Dahir Akuse discussing the reopening of Universal TV office in Somaliland since the television channel has been suspended by the government of Somaliland.
The minister, speaking at the press conference held at his office, stated the government removed the ban on Universal TV, a local television channel which the government previously barred from operating inside Somaliland. Earlier, the government said the television channel broadcasted politically irrelevant satire and ridiculed the president of Somaliland, Ahmed Mohamed Mahmoud Silanu. The television channel also violated the constitution of Somaliland and broadcasted false and fabricated news stories several times. Minister of Information, Culture and National Guidance officially announced the permission that the government gave to Universal TV once again to operate inside the country due to subsequent talks held with cultural leaders who urged the government to lift the ban on the television channel. The minister stressed that the government always pays respect to cultural leaders, so that the government, fulfilling requests submitted by the cultural leaders, removed the ban on Universal Television. This was also due to apology provided by the owner of the television channel recently.
You still tuned to the English news program on Somaliland National Television, the only Somali-speaking channel with an English news program. And now for our international headlines in detail. Security forces are on high alert in Iraq as the Shiite Muslims gather for ceremonies to mark the religious holiday of Ashura.
There are fears that extremists may try to target the millions of pilgrims who take part in the events, with heavy casualties and attacks in previous years. The presence of ISIL militants in the country has heightened those fears. ISIL has previously described Shiite Muslims as infidels who deserve to be killed, forcing local communities to take extra security precautions. During the ceremonies, people hid themselves and gashed their heads. Under the rule of Saddam Hussein, such events were banned under secular laws.
Ukraine's president has called an emergency meeting of his security chiefs following Sunday's election in the separatist east of the country. As expected, Donetsk and Luhansk voted in rebel leaders in polls denounced by Kiev as illegitimate. President Petro Poroshenko say the elections could derail the peace process. The Swedish election are brutal violation of the Minsk Protocol of September 5th. The Minsk Protocol provides for the holding of early local elections in the area of Donbass solely under the laws of Ukraine. We provide them with the given opportunity. The 1st of November 2nd jeopardizes the entire peace process, the beginning of which has been achieved through outstanding effort. While the West and the European Union have commended the votes, there has been also no official reaction from Russian President Vladimir Putin. Washington says there will be further sanctions if Moscow continues to flout the Minsk deal. A nominal ceasefire has been in place in East Ukraine since September 5th, but there have been repeated violations by both sides. That's all the news we have for you tonight. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.